a Yorkshire Proactive in London, and joining us today from Shield Therapeutics is Tim Watts. A very good morning to you, Tim.
Good morning, Katie. Thanks for having me.
Pleasure as always. So you've updated investors on the status of your efforts to commercialise Accrufer, the iron deficiency treatment in the US markets. Tim, maybe you talk us through this and what's the update here?
Yeah, that's right, Katie. I think the first thing I'd like to talk about briefly is the cash position, because I know that some investors have been a little bit concerned about that, because we previously said that our cash runway was till sometime in the first quarter, and clearly we're getting closer to the first quarter of 21 now. And we've announced that we've been able to secure some shareholder loans from a couple of our shareholders, one of whom's a director. So we're very grateful for their confidence in the business and the fact that they were willing to advance us what will amount to about £4.4 million, which should see us through until the end of 2021. So it gives us a good extension of the runway to get the US commercialization sorted out.
Absolutely. So it's bought you this time and this confidence here. So what's the plan going forward in terms of this US licensing?
Yeah. So as people who follow us know, we have been following a path in the US of seeking to out-license the product. The product was approved, as you said, for the treatment of iron deficiency in adults by the FDA in July of 2019. It's already on the market, approved and on the market in Europe, and we have a commercialization partner in China as well. So we've got sort of Europe and China, if you like, taken care of. And the company had started really with a strategy of out-licensing the product in the US, which would be consistent with the approach we've taken in Europe and China. But as we've touched on in the RNS, we've had some frustrations along the way with that license process. We've had lots of interest. Mm-hmm. A lot of that interest has come from quite small companies who are focused on a specific therapy areas. And one of the things about iron deficiency is it occurs in all sorts of illnesses, whether it be oncology, cardiology, gastroenterology, or nephrology, lots and lots of areas. And so when you talk to a company and they say, well, we want to sell it in nephrology, you say, great, and the financial terms might look great, but how are you going to then sell this product across all these other areas and so that we get our royalties? And so, you know, one of the things we've been struggling with is how we really make sure we get the value from a license partner, because they may be too narrowly focused.
Sorry, you're saying the interest is there, you want bigger.
Well, that's been part of the case. We also talk in the RNS briefly about we've got very close on a few occasions. And so for example, a couple of occasions, we've got all the way through the process right up to having all the formal agreements put in place. And we're talking about probably something like 100, 130 pages of license agreement, 30 to 40 pages of manufacturing and supply agreement, only to have those deals fail at the last minute, because the other party has had some issue in their business, which has meant they've had to change tack and drop out. So so hugely frustrating, obviously, when that happens, because you're investing probably 6-7 months work in that. It takes a long time to get the way through all of that. And so it's been very frustrating. And so what that led us to do and start thinking about in the summer was, we can't necessarily rely on third parties to come and sign up. They can get very close and fail at the last minute for whatever reason. So we really started thinking we better start developing an insurance policy of our own so that where we remain in control. And that led us down the thinking of, well, could we potentially launch Accrufer in the US ourselves? And of course, if you launch it yourselves, you can then take 100% of the value of the product. Mm-hmm. If you license it to somebody else, you're going to get perhaps 25-35%, 40%, if you absolutely, things work out brilliantly, of the value of the product. So it's potentially much more value to the shareholders if we do it ourselves. We started to look, closely at this. One of the things that we'd seen through the license process is we were approached by quite a lot of small companies who didn't already have substantial sales and marketing infrastructure and presence of their own. Some of them were even brand new companies backed by deep-pocketed private equity investors who wanted to build a company from scratch and thought Accrufer would be a great company to start with. But of course, as we looked at those sorts of companies and they were telling us, explaining to us how they would go about launching the product and, you know, what they saw as the pricing, et cetera. We were learning a lot. And we asked ourselves, well, why couldn't we do that? Why do we have to, you know, we, if they can start from scratch and do it, why can't we start from scratch and do it? So we started to build as an insurance policy, let's see what would happen. And we've now got to the stage where we still have some license discussions going on with several companies. But as I say, we are building up, we've got some US consultants who we are talking to in great detail, and who are building up in fine detail how we would go about launching the product. And that ranges everything from the logistics of how do we get the product from Europe, where we manufacture it, into pharmacies in every state in the US, and, you know, how does that supply chain work? How do we make that work? What about the pricing and the pricing negotiations and the market access? How do you go to the insurance companies in the states where a lot of the payment is made and convince them that this is the right price and this is how we price it? And what about discounting for patients in the states who aren't insured? And so we've got several consultants that we're talking to helping us build up very detailed plans. And so we've now got, and what we're trying to show to investors in the RNS today, mm-hmm. is we've got options. And if the license route doesn't work out, we believe we're building an option which will take us down a route where we could launch the product ourselves. And as I say, we ought to be able to generate far more value long-term for shareholders if we do go down that route. Clearly, there's a different set of risks. We have been asked about risks. I think there's probably three risks. One is execution of the launch. Mm-hmm. But the more we've seen other companies and talked to them and thought about it ourselves, is we're not convinced that us doing it ourselves brings any greater execution risk than relying on somebody else, who might be a small company. And so we think we can make that execution risk broadly similar. There's also a commitment risk. We will be 100% committed to the product. If we license it to somebody else, we can never guarantee that over the 15-year patent life that we've got, that company will remain quite as committed to the product as we are. And then people will say, well, there's also a finance risk. And of course, if we do a license deal, we should be able to bring in an upfront of several tens of millions of dollars, perhaps. Whereas if we launch the product ourselves, we may have to spend, and we've indicated in the RNS that we might have to spend $30 to $40 million dollars in launching the product before we get to break even. So there is a financial risk, but then the risk reward ratio, of course, if you launch it yourself, is very much greater, or very much better. So we've looked at all those things, and we really wanted to explain to the market, this is what we're doing. You know, we now have options as to which path we go down, and when we, you know, a little bit further down the road with both the license and the US development, we'll be in a position to make a judgment as to which we think is the best route to go down.
Yeah. Clearly, you're very confident in the product if you're going to be doing this solo. You've mentioned some of the risks there, execution, commitment, finance here, but presumably you're hoping to reap the benefits. Maybe in regards to this, just remind us of the attributes of Accrufer, if you can.
Yeah. So Accrufer, as I said, I think at the outset, is an oral product. It's a novel oral formulation, so it doesn't have some of the tolerance issues which the older generic oral products have. It is a well-tolerated product, and it's effective. We've also compared the product with intravenous therapy, and what you can see from that is Accrufer would be very good at long-term maintenance, because you just have to take two capsules a day, one in the morning, one in the evening. You can do that at home. And Accrufer maintains your hemoglobin levels at where they need to be, mm-hmm. and so particularly in a world where COVID is making intravenous look less attractive, because you don't want patients going into hospitals, particularly if they've got underlying health issues. Mm-hmm. There's some real wind behind the Accrufer opportunity, we believe, at the moment. And it is a very large market. I mean, we estimate there's something in the region of 10 million prescriptions for iron therapy a year at the moment in the US. And the vast majority of those actually are for oral products. Mm-hmm. So for Accrufer, which we believe can sit between and cannibalize both the oral products and the intravenous products, we think there's a huge opportunity.
Absolutely, 10 million. In regards to the timeline here, some people, well, especially your investors, they're going to be wondering, I appreciate there's lots of conversations going on at the moment, but when do you imagine or hope that one of these might come to fruition?
I think this is a product that's been approved already for a year and a half. We need to get this product to the market as quickly as we can. So I think that's probably in 2 to 3 months' time, it will become much clearer as to which path we're going down.
Yeah. Brilliant. Tim Watts, thank you very much indeed from Shield Therapeutics here on Proactive London this morning.
Katie, thanks very much.